Hi, today we discuss composite materials used in wind energy applications. After Fukushima catastrophe, nuclear energy is considered to be dangerous. A large region of the highly developed country was fully destroyed and became dangerous for living. Hundreds of thousands of people lost their property, houses, jobs. But using fossil fuels is dangerous too, in middle and long term. Environment is destroyed. Global warming is coming. Even now we have very unstable weather conditions in Europe, very warm or very cold days both in winter and summer. That is why renewable energy attracts more and more attention. European Union plans to get 20% of energy from renewables before 2050. To realize this goal, one has to increase wind capacity by two orders. It can be achieved only by building a number of offshore wind parks. The EU offshore wind energy capacity is expected to grow by 21% annually. Offshore wind turbines are very difficult to repair. The maintenance costs accounts for 18 to 23% in European offshore wind farms. A wind turbine should work for 20 to 25 years without repair. In reality, their lifetime is between 10 to 15 years. There are estimations that the failure rates of blades are in the order of 20% within 3 years after installation. How can we increase the lifetime of wind turbines and prevent their failure? Let us look at the construction, load and requirements toward wind blades. A blade consists of two faces, on the suction side and the pressure side, joined together and stiffened either by one or several integral webs, or by a box beam. The box beam inside the blade is adhesively joined to the shell. Wind turbine blades are subject to the external loading, which includes the flapwise and edgewise bending loads, gravitational loads, inertia forces, loads due to pitch acceleration, as well as torsional loading. The flapwise load is caused mainly by the wind pressure, while the edgewise load is caused both by gravitational forces and torque load. The biggest edgewise bending moment is at the blade root. Wind blades represent the most important composite-based part of a wind turbine. Blades are produced from long fiber-reinforced polymers. In the composites, long fibers ensure longitudinal stiffness and strength, while the resin matrix is responsible for fracture toughness, delamination strength and out-of-plane strength and stiffness of the composite. With increasing the fiber content in composites, the stiffness and strength increase proportionally. But at high volume content of fibers there might be dry areas without resin between fibers. Then fatigue strength of the composite reduces. Most often, E-glass fibers are used as main reinforcement in the composites. E-glass is borosilicate glass called electric glass for its high electric resistance. Many investigations toward the development of fibers, which are stronger than the usual E-glass fibers, have been carried out. The high-strength fibers, which are still used seldom in practice, but represent a promising source of the composite materials improvement, include glass fibers with modified compositions, carbon fibers, basalt and aramid fibers. S-glass is high-strength glass. S-glass was developed in the 1960s for military applications. It has 40% higher tensile and flexural strengths, and 10% higher compressive strength and flexural modulus, than the E-glass. R-glass fibers, introduced by Vetrotex in 1968, are produced with a calcium aluminosilicate glass with less silica and added oxides. In 2006, Owens Corning Company developed twin-strand glass fibers, which have 15% higher stiffness and up to 30% higher strength when compared to traditional glass fiber reinforcements. Carbon fibers attracted large interest of industry and research community as a very promising alternative to the glass fibers. Carbon fibers have much higher stiffness and lower density than the glass fibers. Thus, they allow the thinner blade profile as well as stiffer and lighter blades. However, they have relatively low damage tolerance, compressive strength and ultimate strain, and are 7 to 20 expensive than the E-glass fibers. Carbon fiber reinforced composites are very sensitive to the fiber misalignment and waviness. Even small misalignments lead to the strong reduction of compressive and fatigue strength. Further alternative options of non-glass, high-strength fibers include aramid and basalt fibers. Aramid fibers have high mechanical strength, and are tough and damage-tolerant. However, the compressive strength of aramid fibers is even lower than that of carbon. Aramid fibers were introduced by the company DuPont as Kevlar. Aramid fibers absorb moisture, can degrade under the influence of ultraviolet radiation and have relatively low adhesion to polymer resins. Basalt fibers represent also an interesting alternative to the glass fibers. Basalt fibers are 30% stronger, 15.20% stiffer and 8.10% lighter than e-glass, and cheaper than the carbon fibers. Polymers represent the common matrix material for the wind blade composites. Thermosets-based composites represent around 80% of the market of reinforced polymers. The advantages of thermosets are the possibility of room or low temperature cure, and lower viscosity. Initially, polyester resins were used for composite blades. Epoxy resins are used now most often as matrices of wind blade composites. While polyester is less expensive and easier to process, epoxy systems are stronger and more durable as compared with polyester resins. Thermoplastics represent an interesting alternative to the thermoset matrices. The important advantage of thermoplastic composites is their recyclability. Their disadvantages are the necessity of high processing temperatures and difficulties to manufacture large parts, due to high viscosity. Let us look at manufacturing technologies of wind blade composites. Initially, the production of wind blades was often initiated by yacht and boat building companies, and using their experience with boat building. At this time, the blades were often produced using the wet hand layup technology, in open molds. The fibers was impregnated using paint brushes and rollers. The shells were adhesively bonded together, or to the spars. This technology was used mainly to produce small and medium-sized blades. For larger blades, the web were inserted and adhesively bonded between two sides, and the plies with more fiber content were used. The disadvantages of the open mold technology are high labor costs, relatively low quality of products and environmental problems. Currently, the most widely used technology is the resin infusion technology. Fibers are placed in a closed and sealed mold, and resin is injected into the mold cavity under pressure. After the resin fills all the volume between fibers, the component is cured with heat. The resin infusion technologies can be divided into two groups: resin transfer molding, resin injection under pressure higher than atmospheric 1, and vacuum-assisted resin transfer molding, or vacuum infusion process, when resin is injected under vacuum or pressure lower than atmospheric, typically, under a vacuum bag. The prepreg technology, adapted from the aircraft industry, is based on utilizing pre-impregnated composite fibers, which already contain an amount of the matrix material bonding them together. Repreg, widely used, for instance, by the Danish wind turbine producer Vestas, allows the industrial impregnation of fibers, and then forming the impregnated fibers to complex shapes. Lately, the automated tape layup, automated fiber placement, two pieces or segment wind blades, enhanced finishing technologies come into use to improve quality and reduce costs of the composite blade manufacturing. Service properties and lifetime of wind blades depend to a large degree on the availability of manufacturing defects in the blades. The typical manufacturing defects are delaminations, wrinkles, matrix cracks, dry zones and voids, defects in adhesive joints, local properties variations, fiber defects and misalignments, undercured and overcured regions, fiber, matrix debondings, and so on. The degradation of the blades under loading is determined by the microscale cracking, debonding and deformation. The main mechanisms are fiber cracking, matrix failure and interface debonding. The load is borne mainly by fibers. If the load exceeds some critical level, fibers might fail. That may cause failure of other fibers. The cracks in the fibers cause a higher stress concentration in the matrix, what can lead to the matrix cracking. compressive strength of composites is often sufficiently lower than their tensile strength. Let us summarize our observations. Development of new resin systems which have low viscosity and better wetting of fibers can lead to blades with less defects. Promising materials system for wind blades include thermoplastic resins, high-strength glass and carbon fibers. A few words about myself. My name is Leon Misniewski and I am senior researcher at the Technical University of Denmark. Thank you very much for your attention.